Don't tell me about the money. First, this dude won't talk about the money, Enrico.
How much longer, Mr. Corbett?
Well, the west side's about half done, but south side, that's another story. I'd have to say at least 5 or 6 more hours.
Oh, so we're only one day behind schedule.
What's the story, Jack?
Come on, people. They don't pay us by the hours.
They're slow as hell, Paul. Half of them don't even seem to understand English.
This is South America, Jack. What do you want?
How about some water?
Be careful of what you wish for, Mr. Corbin.
What? Oh, shit.
Looks like rain. Better radio the chart.
Yeah, I think you're right. Wagon wheel, you copy?
I copy, Mr. Corbin.
Let's head on back.
If he thinks we're gonna get all these people out of here in one trip, he's full of shit.
You go tell Paul we're gonna have to be a few behind for a second trip. We can't get them all on one trip.
Come on, people, we got a rainstorm coming. A rainstorm. Vamos, come on, arriba. Come on, let's go. Pack it up, let's go.
Just some shit, man. Leave it to Evan to make the decision on who stays and who goes. No shit. Why the hell is it always raining here anyway?
That's why they call it the rainforest, you moron.
What the hell is that?
I don't know, a howling monkey or something.
What the hell? That was close.
It's getting closer.
I'm getting out of here.
What the hell is doing that?
No, no, wait. I'm gonna go check it out.
Oh, shit.
I get the ladies.
Hey, man, it's no problem. I just find a real nice-looking lady, and I go up to her and I say, hey, how you doing? Can I be of any service? And then I give her that look, man.
A look?
A look. A look. You give her a look.
Yeah, man, you know, a look, you know. Up and down, give her a wink, and then like a real nasty smile. She get the picture.
Right. A smile. Then she'll smile right back at you and say, kiss my ass, you horny bastard.
Be happy to kiss her ass. Dude, I'd be happy to kiss her anywhere she...
We're off the ship, man, 10 minutes ago.
Getting off the ship. They already made that deal, the little negotiation to sell their cargo in here to some sideshow, freak show, whatever you want to call it.
You've seen it?
Fucking A, I saw it. It was big and fast, fast and ugly. Man, this clean waste to die.
I want to see it.
Nobody's going in there. Big Mother, eat you alive. Plus, it will get out.
They got a safety system, don't they? Reinforced steel bars, right?
That system no longer exists, man. Tore the bars right off. Believe me, you're better off if you don't see it, man. Big motherfucker will give you nightmares.
Your ball.
Come on, Mike. This is the game-winning point. Stop him.
You suck.
All right, guys. That's enough. I gotta get to work.
As you can see, Lieutenant, this is clearly the most important zoological discovery since the okapi was found in the Congo, 1900.
What is it that you're getting at, Mr. Murphy?
No one's ever seen an animal such as this before. No one knows what to expect. I don't think we have the proper containment facilities or the qualified men to keep things running smoothly during the transfers.
I trust my men. They've been trained to deal with such a situation.
No one knows what to expect from a situation like this. No one, including your men. Allowing yourself to believe so will only have you winding up like Connor.
Connor's men didn't have a chance. He didn't know the dangers, and besides, that was 8 years ago.
Doesn't matter when it was, whether it was 8 years ago or 8 years from now. There's a genuine risk doing this sort of thing. Do you have any idea of the consequences if you were to, well, fuck up?
We don't fuck up. It's our job to make sure that things go right.
That's not the way I see it, Lieutenant. This is gonna blow up in your face, and I don't plan on being here when it finally does. The way I see it, Lieutenant, this operation is an accident waiting to happen.
Government prick. Gate, you copy? Don't talk back, just give you a walkie if you copy, over. I got two men down, Sanders, Regis, you copy? Harris, you copy? Sanders? Hey there. This is Carter calling. Come in.
This thing.
From the award-winning filmmakers of the BBC, the most astonishing and electrifying home video collection ever released, Killing for a Living. Narrated by Academy Award winner Anthony Hopkins. You'll witness incredible footage of the deadly struggle for survival in the animal world. The brutal conflict between hunter and hunted, predator.
I am at the Oceana Naval Base where the first effects of the statewide police strike are beginning to be felt. It seems that early this morning around 11 a.m., nine bodies were discovered here, brutally murdered to the point of almost no recognition. While the city and state police were notified, neither responded to the call. Major Marcus Nelson, a commanding officer at the base, had to take things into his own hands. He had this to say.
In light of the problems our local law enforcement agency has been having, these murders could not have happened at a worse time. As commander of this base, I have set up a special investigation team consisting of my own men. They will conduct a thorough and complete investigation of the crime. At this time, however, we have no leads.
With the police strike still raging after 6 months, there seems to be no reprieve in sight. City and state officials are now looking towards Washington for help. This is Elizabeth Graham signing off. Back to you, Bob.
When is it all going to end?
It's not, Shane. It's not. I'm gonna take you and Dev home first before I go pick up Karen at work, okay?
That's cool. Can you drop me off at Debbie's?
Yeah, sure. Hey, isn't your brother supposed to be coming in for the summer?
Ingram? Yeah, he got in last night.
Is he?
Yep. Same old Ingram.
It's gonna be a fun summer.
Oh God, not like last summer.
Taco Bell thing, right?
Yeah.
You still think he has a thing for Debbie?
I don't know. Probably.
You don't still think she has feelings for him, do you? I hear you, man. Ingram could get her in a lot of trouble. Not to mention any bystanders.
He was always doing something, wasn't he?
Shit, yeah. He always got caught, too.
That's just it. He likes being caught.
Why?
Confrontation. Competition. He lives for it. Why do you think he got thrown out of the Corps?
You guys talking about Ingram?
Yeah. Ingram's back in town for the summer.
You guys ready?
Wait, I'm not ready yet.
Okay. We're gonna be in the car.
Okay.
Hey man, you want to do something this weekend?
Yeah, sure, what?
I don't know, I think about taking the girls to, you know, a movie, dinner, something like that.
Sounds cool to me, man. But Ingram will probably want to come along.
Yeah, that's no problem.
Hey Debbie, you game for this weekend?
Hey, yeah, what?
Thinking about going out to dinner.
What do you want me to tell him, Karen, huh? Sorry, Ingram, not this weekend. You got other things to do.
Yes, that's exactly what I want you to tell him.
No, Karen, he's an old pal. We go way back.
One weekend with Ingram can mean a trip to court.
Now, wait a minute.
You know I'm right. You know the way Ingram is. You remember what happened last summer.
Yeah, I remember, but I'm sure everything's changed.
I'll be the judge of that. So when's he coming over?
Tomorrow, round one.
So what do you guys have planned for this festive weekend?
I don't know. Me and Shane were thinking something along the lines of dinner and a movie, you know? Something like that.
But where does Ingram fit into all this? Well, Shane and Debbie would be together, and I was hoping you and I could be together, and Ingram would just be along for the ride, right?
Right. What the hell was that?
Mike, what are you doing? is wrong with you?
I don't know. I guess it was a deer.
A deer. You stopped the car for a deer. Have you never seen a deer before?
I don't know. I guess it was just a big deer. That's all. Come on, let's get out of here. Chance to sleep in since my parents left town. I thought this was gonna be a nice relaxing vacation for me with them gone. I only got another month and it's going to sleep again.
It's
oh.
8 o'clock and I'm gonna be late.
So?
Besides, today's your big day with Ingram.
That's a cause worth getting up for.
Spend the night, you have to learn to get up early in the morning. The early bird gets the worm.
I'm not a bird, Karen.
Trees, no going in houses.
Why can't we climb in trees?
Because Chris can't climb trees.
I can too climb trees.
No, you can't, big baby. Billy, you're it. Count to 25. Go!
Ingram, you son of a bitch. How the hell you been?
Good to see you, Mike.
Oh, man, it's been a long time. Come on in.
My compliments on a very well-kept house.
Okay. How's Maria?
What's on the agenda for this weekend?
Well,
Ingram, how are you?
Debbie, how you been?
Fine. So what you been up to in Ohio?
You're so fine, I could look at you all day long.
Hey, you better watch yourself there, bro.
Hey, come on, guys, cut it out. You're gonna break something, guys. Cut it out. Come on.
Hey, pull the fist to me.
All right, man, come on, cut it out.
Come on. I put my fist back in my
mouth. It's okay. Group, get back up on the couch. Come on, Shane. Cut it out. Don't break something in my house, dude. All right, man, calm down, man. Just sit down. Shane, calm down.
Check this out, guys. On the way over here, some woman, she jumps out in front of my car and near about run her over. She was yelling about some kid she lost or something.
Ingram, you took the time to break. I'm proud of you.
Learn something new every day.
A kid's missing?
Yeah, I think so. She seemed pretty frantic.
That poor woman. Mike, I'm gonna go see if she needs any help.
Yeah.
Karen, sweet and terrible as always.
Yeah.
Boy, bet she hates my guts, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I assume you'll get something to eat.
How about Taco Bell?
Sounds good to me. Ingram, you think you keep your car outside this time?
I guess. I'll drive.
We're going out to Taco Bell. You want to come?
No, I'm going to help this lady look for a kid.
Well, you want me to bring you back something?
No, I'll grab something later.
Okay. Well, I left the house unlocked for you.
Okay.
Okay. Be back later.
Love you.
I don't know, man. I don't know. Karen, what's wrong? What happened?
This little boy. He was killed. Somebody cut off his head.
It's okay. It's okay. It's all right. It's okay. It's okay. Look, did the police come?
Paramedics. The boy was cut to shreds. There was blood all over the place. All over me.
It's okay, look. Come on, let me get you home. Come on, I'll take you home. Let's go.
I borrowed one of your shirts.
It's all right. It's all right. I'll be right back, guys. And Deb, you want to ride home?
Yeah.
Give me a call tomorrow.
Okay, later, Ingram.
Later, Deb.
I'll call you, Shane.
Does this happen a lot around here?
No, never.
For as long as I've lived around here, nothing like this has ever happened.
I can't believe the police department didn't even send out a squad car to check out the scene of the crime.
Cops have better things to do these days than protect and serve. No shit.
This city brought the strike upon itself.
Good.
Good.
You've changed. What happened to the Mike I knew a year ago?
People change, Ingram.
Change is one thing, transform is another.
Well, at least it doesn't get into trouble anymore.
Are you kidding? Me and Mike were trouble.
Well, Ingram, those days are over now.
Not for me. I'm gonna have a little more excitement for my dying day.
Maybe that's a problem. You stay on this road, Ingram, and that day will be here before you know it. I'm going to bed. You got yourselves out and ready to leave.
What's up for tomorrow?
Probably nothing. Karen's got to work, and I don't want you feeling like going out anymore.
Going to Mom's. You going with me?
Yeah, I guess.
See you later, Mike.
Later.
Drive safely.
Thank you.
think Ingram's pissed at you.
So?
So nothing. I just think Ingram's pissed at you.
I don't care.
I just think he needs a woman.
He gets one every night.
No, I mean the kind of woman that can change a man, alter the course and direction of his life. You know what I mean.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean.
I think you thought he had that with Debbie.
Yeah, well, you came along and screwed things up a great deal.
Well, I always cared for and loved Debbie. And when I found out she felt the same for me, I knew what I had to do. I'm just sorry as hell for Ingram.
Yeah, well, he got over it.
Yeah, after he took out his frustrations on that superior officer at boot camp, threw the poor dude off the roof.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he regrets that now.
The only thing he regrets is that they didn't meet on a taller building. Well, since Debbie doesn't feel much like going to movies anymore, Karen's working.
How about some pool?
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, it's better than nothing.
So disgusting.
Was there something you needed?
Yeah, me and Brian are going to movies at 8, and I was wondering if you'd like to come along.
You don't want me to go alone.
I just thought you'd like to get out.
If I wanted to go out, I'd go out somewhere with Shane.
I'll take that as a no. You know, if that thing ever gets loose in the house, you're going to be in big trouble.
What's the matter?
It's just a little lizard. Wouldn't hurt you.
I hate lizards.
I was in the neighborhood, just decided to stop by today.
There's food in the kitchen if you're hungry. Help yourself.
Thanks, where's Shane?
He's out shooting pool or something with Mike. I thought you were hanging out with your old buddies tonight.
Gave Benny Boy a call. Phone just rang and rang. Must have skipped out of your song.
He's probably smoking a joint in his backyard or something.
Yeah. What's Angela up to tonight?
Oh, she's at the movies with her boyfriend.
Brian?
Yeah.
Still going out for 3 years, huh?
Yeah, I think he's going to propose soon.
No shit, really?
Yeah, sometime this weekend.
Think she'll accept?
Oh, yeah, she's crazy about Brian.
Man, going straight through me. Wait. You gotta get over her. Careful of what?
There's something out there.
There's no ledge. There's nothing to stand on.
I saw...
There's no ledge out there. No place for it to stand. It was just a tree limb broken off in the storm.
It wasn't a tree limb.
If it'll make you feel better, I'll go out and have a look.
Forget it. Just stay in the house.
No, I'll just go take a look. Be right back.
But don't go. I mean, it could be dangerous.
Debbie, you worry too much. You know what a cautious guy I am.
large carnivores.
Was gone. I think I'm losing my mind.
It's okay.
Debbie, listen to me.
What was it?
Eyes. I looked right through me, like it knew I was terrified. It was a dragon. I'll never forget that scream.
You need to get some sleep.
I can't sleep. Every time I shut my eyes,
come on, I need to get you upstairs.
You think she'll be all right?
Who gives a shit whether or not she'll be all right? Ingram's dead, damn it, and someone's running around out there getting away with murder.
Come on, Shane, you don't mean it.
Get away from me, man.
I'm sorry, guys. I just...
It's okay, Shane, we understand.
There's someone in the backyard.
Shane, wait! Shane, what are you
Shane,
doing,
no.
man? Get the hell back
no.
here! Hey, man, wait, what the hell are you doing?
Shane, no!
What the hell do you think you're doing, huh?
just be asking the questions, boy. Gordon, why don't you help our friend to his feet? I am Maurice Steele, and these are my associates, David Grissom and Gordon Mitchell. Shall we go in? I believe all your questions can be explained.
All of them?
Oh yes, almost certainly.
All right, is somebody gonna tell me what the hell's going on here?
So where do you want me to start?
The beginning's always a good place.
You got a smile in here, boys.
Good. I like that. We're hunters. On the trail of a killer.
Bounty hunters.
What?
Animals. The large animals.
And very dangerous ones at that.
What are you saying? Ingram was killed by some kind of animal?
Bullshit!
Not just your friend. It's killed several times within the past 48 hours.
12 or more to be precise.
The boy.
Yes.
Is it like a lion or something?
Debbie was rambling on about something. A dragon. She said she saw a dragon.
No, it's not a dragon. But I'll tell you this. It's more a dragon than a lion.
What?
It's a beast. A monster, if you will. A reptilian creature of the jungle. Hear me out, young man. Do you not think there are animals in this world which you have never seen but in fact do exist, living undiscovered in the deepest rainforests?
It originates in the rainforests of South America. But David had an encounter with one in the African Congo about 3 years ago.
Never seen anything quite like it. Very fast.
Extremely fast.
Extremely intelligent. These creatures do exist. And what we're after is here, in your city. And it will kill.
For food?
Oh yes, they never pass up prey.
Man killers.
And these animals don't stop, like the lion after its first kill, but instead kill again, even when it's not hungry.
When you say extremely fast, what do you mean? How fast?
Fast enough to run down a man. And kill him.
And when you say extremely intelligent?
Oh, they're smart. Very smart. Play games with it, they will. Trick into the open. And they'll reach in. Get you.
Don't be misled. They can never achieve any reading, writing, or arithmetic, but they are quite clever. The older, larger ones are very instinctive.
In any case, I'm tired and interested in going upstairs and getting some sleep. Good. You need your rest. And you don't need to worry about getting in here. You're more than safe in the house.
If it's so intelligent, why can't it find a way into the house?
Oh, I don't doubt that it can get in. As a matter of fact, I know it can, but you have to remember something. This beast is from the jungle, and has no experience with houses whatsoever. It wouldn't enter because of the smell. Unnatural, and it doesn't like that.
The thing on the road.
Oh my God.
That's why it didn't attack.
And that would explain why it didn't come in the house after Debbie.
One thing is for certain. Now that this animal's had a taste for human flesh, it'll be back. For more easy prey. Our job is to stop it.
Doesn't stay on the ground long. After it makes a kill, it takes the carcass up to a safe place high in the tree.
Nocturnal.
Unfortunately.
It only means we move in on it during the day, when it's in a tree, sleeping.
Difficult, considering the number of trees in this area.
We think we have a solid pattern nailed down on this thing, and we're moving in on a certain force tomorrow at dawn.
I'm going with you.
Don't be an idiot, Shane.
No, I'm serious. I fired a gun before.
Besides not knowing much about the way this thing stalks, you don't even have a gun.
Got my brother's 45.
He taught me how to use it.
Forget it, kid. Too dangerous.
No, David. He said he used a gun before. I say let the kid have his chance.
What?
Maurice, you can't be serious.
You ever been hunting, son?
Yes. Turkey hunting in the spring.
And did you down that turkey?
No, I missed.
Then if you do decide to come with us, there'll be no missing. No second chance. That thing will be at you. soon did he think? After the first shot, it made me have 5 seconds. 5 seconds, maybe less, before it'll bite into you and tear you to pieces. It's a night feeder, so for safety's sake, I suggest we stay here for the night. It's out there, right now.
Still going on?
Yeah.
Should we consider?
Why? You don't think I can handle it? Because I can't.
You don't know what you're dealing with.
Everything can be dealt with.
You like living dangerously, don't you?
Yep. I love it.
We'll be leaving in 15 minutes. Be ready.
Camouflage?
Doesn't really matter.
Bad eyesight, huh?
Oh no, quite the contrary. This beast has very good eyesight.
Then why aren't we wearing camouflage?
Because it doesn't matter.
Look, this beast, it can detect movement from 700 yards away in heavy brush. So whatever you do, do not move. Otherwise?
Otherwise?
Otherwise, it's gonna hunt us.
Great.
Are you sure you don't want to go back?
Yes, I don't want to be by myself.
I think you could have talked to Angela into staying home with you.
I'm not going to do that. She was going over to Brian's.
She would have been happy to stay with you.
Let's just don't worry about it, okay, Mike?
Debbie, I'm concerned about you. After what happened last night with Ingram.
Let's just not talk about it anymore.
All right, I'm sorry.
You don't believe me, do you?
Debbie, I
know it sounds nuts, but I'm telling the truth. This will all be over soon.
Something?
Yes.
Gordon! David!
Blood.
Besides, you lied to me.
Karen, do you expect me to stay home after what I saw last night? Besides, I'm not going in the woods. I'm not that crazy.
Shane?
I still have my doubts, okay?
Mike?
He'll be okay.
I'll be okay.
This is it. There's a blood trail leading off into the woods. We follow it, we find it. Like to live dangerously?
I love it.
Let's go.
Is everything gonna be okay?
Oh yes, Steele wouldn't let him come along if he didn't think he could handle it.
Are you sure?
Look, one of us are going to be with him once we get inside the forest. Look, if it makes you feel any better, I'll be with him.
Oh yes, I feel so much better now.
Yeah, I see.
That wasn't very nice.
Well,
I'm off.
It's not too late. You don't have to go.
This is the last time. Mr. Steele thinks so anyway. I'll be back. I swear to you.
Gordon, you follow tree line that way, through the house, then head in. David, straight in, straight up the middle. Take him with you. I'll be on the far right, flanking positions. If there are any problems, use the walk. Be careful. If it attacks, it'll attack from above. Let's move out. Don't move.
You moved! Where the hell did it go?
Thank you.
something?
Where's Debbie?
I saw her get in the van. Are you okay?
I'm fine. It never saw me, I think. Are you all right?
Stepped on me.
Mike.
Karen, slowly get out of the car and head for the van.
I'm not gonna make a move without you.
Okay. Let's go together. Quietly.
Get out of here.
Where are the others?
David Grissom's dead. I don't know about the others.
What if they're dead?
Then we have a serious problem.
Do you realize how unlikely it is that you or I or any of us is gonna get out of this alive?
It's gone.
Willing to take a step outside and find out?
We have to get out of here. How far are we from the road? Too far. We'd never make it. But if we could, someone would see us and help us. It's still too far. You saw how fast it was. We just can't stay here. Steele and the others are probably dead.
We don't know that.
Where are they? They might not know what happened yet.
Well, in that case, they might not be back until nightfall.
Maurice, this wasn't supposed to happen. I thought we'd worked through all the problems, prepared for anything.
I'll be damned.
Are you even hearing me?
The bite patterns. No question it was a male. A young one. We're fortunate.
Fortunate?
Yes. Very fortunate. Another one will be larger. And much harder to kill.
Maurice, you of all people should know that all those bastards are hard to kill.
Yes. Some more than others. But lucky this wasn't a dominant female. You know what they're capable of.
Let's go. What about him?
What about him? You've got things to do.
It's the radio. Find it. Found it. Hello? Who is this?
Hello? Hello?
Let me see.
Hello?
Hello?
This is Gordon. Are y'all okay?
This is Shane. We're all right. Where the hell are you, Gordon?
You have no idea how extremely lucky you are to be alive right now.
Yeah. It's a good thing I had my Wheaties this morning.
I saw the commotion by the cars. Then the dust rose up and I couldn't see anything. When it cleared, everyone was gone. I thought you'd all died.
But how long can we keep that as a thought, not a reality?
Well, that all depends on whether you still like to live dangerously.
Not really.
Well, I have a plan. I don't know for sure if it'll work, but it's the only chance we have at nailing this thing.
Try not to keep me in suspense.
Okay, I'm on the far side of the woods to your left. It's in the woods to your right. I'm not gonna be able to give you a clear shot of this thing unless it comes out. One of you could lure it.
Lure it?
Lure it, he's gotta be nuts!
There's a pool over here next to this house.
I don't think anybody's really up for a swim right now.
One of you can make it to the pool, I'd have a nice clear shot at it. And that person, even if I didn't drop it, would be safe in the pool.
How far away is the pool?
Christ, I'd say about 75 yards.
We wouldn't make it, not the way that thing runs, like a goddamn cheetah.
That's the only option.
Where's Steel?
He's around.
What do you mean around? Where the hell is he?
He asked me not to tell you.
Why?
He doesn't want to end up like Grissom.
How good is your aim?
Good enough.
I'll go.
Karen, I'm not going to let you go out there.
Mike, I was on the track team in my senior year. I'm the fastest of the four of us.
Forget about it, Karen.
Mike!
Look, that thing's not going to wait out there forever. It's an intelligent creature and it will get bored. There's no reason why it won't tear its way through that van. It can, you know.
Hold on a second, Gordon.
I'm going.
Not going anywhere, Karen.
I can do it, Mike.
Karen, you can't do it. Just stay in here. Either me or Shane will do it. I can't let you go out there.
She was
Gordon, get ready.
No, I can't let you. I'm not going to let her get hurt.
You messed up!
Did it go down?
I don't know. How am I supposed
to? Yes. Yes. He hit it.
Mike said you hit it, but I know it's not dead.
I'm lucky I hit it at all, from this range.
But you missed the first three times that you tried.
I'm not sure I did.
I'm sure you missed. How could you have let this happen? How could you miss?
Can't say. It came out from a different place than I expected, and it was moving too fast.
What happened to Shane?
I'm not sure, he may still be alive, but I'm not in the best places to.
Gordon, what is it?
It's back, it's by the van.
What's it doing?
It's looking for me. Damn, smart. I know someone else is out here.
No, wait a minute.
It might be coming back for the body. No, it's going back. Your friend is still alive.
He's alive? How do you know?
Because if he was dead, it would have moved the body to a safer place. Extremely intelligent. It's trying to lure us out.
Jesus. What do we do now?
If at first you don't succeed...
You don't mean...
The plan will work.
Yeah, your plan worked wonderfully last time.
Shane wasn't fast enough.
How far to the pool?
70 yards at the most. About 200 feet, give or take.
I'll do it.
You sure?
Yes, let's hurry this up before I change my mind.
Instead of sprinting, try to creep your way along as far as you can. This would give you a good head start, if you don't make too much noise opening the doors.
All right, but if things get bad, I'm depending on you to get me out of it.
You have my word.
It's not your word I'm interested in, it's your marksmanship.
All right.
Gone
long, Karen.
Gordon, I'm ready.
Be careful. Be quiet.
I She made it.
Gordon, is Karen all right?
I can't tell.
Gordon! Gordon!
Damn it.
What are you doing?
Creating a diversion. I think it understands English, but I think it gets the general idea.
Come and get it! Dinner served!
I think we've insulted its intelligence. Let's see how smart this thing really is. Let's see if it recognizes this sound.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Thank you.
He's alive.
Gordon!
What?
Oh, glad to see you can make it. This makes you the second man to survive being bit by one of those things.
Yeah, well, it's not that bad, considering.
You should be damn thankful you're still alive.
I'm afraid you're right. I don't think I would have survived, except the big chap's heart wasn't in it.
It was alarmed by Gordon's shots.
Can you remember anything at all?
Of course I remember. You think I could be attacked by a 7-foot, 2,000-pound animal and have it slip my mind? Can you stand? I think so.
Let's check and see if everyone else is all right.
You okay in here?
Yeah, I'm all right. Took a little bite of my arm. Hurts a hell of a lot worse than it is, though.
Wait a minute. Where's Debbie?
I don't know what the hell happened, man. She was in here. We're both in here, man. The goddamn thing attacked us. Shit, I went out the back. I don't know what happened to her, man.
Come on, Gordon. We got a job to do.
What is it?
It's a shirt.
Gordon!
What?
Move!
You're blocking the light. She may still be alive.
What makes you think so?
Only the sleeve is torn.
Which means?
Which means she took it off after she got attacked.
Could have been torn off during the attack.
And if he's torn the shred, that was the case.
There would have been blood.
This prison. Then where'd she go?
I don't know. See if we can determine that.
She's off into the forest.
Why would she just leave?
I don't know. Maybe she's afraid to come back here. In any case, can't look for her tonight. Go. Y'all free to go. Car's been jumped. I get out of here.
Well, what about Debbie?
We'll find her. When we do, we'll bring her back.
Touch it.
Maybe we should get you to the hospital so you can get some stitches.
Maybe.
Stop the car!
What?
What the hell are you talking about?
Stop the car!
Thing.
Got it!
Come on, let's help him out of the water.
Finish it.
It ain't going nowhere. The last round's at the vertebrae. It's paralyzed.
End it. It suffered long enough, and so have we.
It's been fun. But it's either you or me. Gordon, go measure our large friend.
Doesn't look so tough anymore.
12 foot 9 inches long. Nearly 7 feet tall.
How's this gonna be handled?
What do you mean?
A lot of people are dead, Steele. How's it gonna be explained?
It will be covered up, of course. As long as we get the body out here before the press arrives.
So you're just gonna disappear then?
That's a general idea, yes.
So after you're gone, we'll get stuck with all the questions.
They won't know, unless you tell them yourself. A lot of confusion this past week. You'll be lucky to find a Fed who isn't busy trying to make phone calls covering this whole thing up. If somebody does come around asking questions, you never heard of us. If by some chance we're caught, we will extend the same courtesy to you. I'd really hate to leave you guys like this. We're working against the American government now. We really don't have a choice.
Thanks for all your help.
It's nothing. You just better leave. The longer you stay, the less chance you're escaping the press. That'd be bad for all of us. So just bolt.
Uh-huh. Well, I'll be home in about an hour or two. I love you too. Bye. Hello? Angela, it's me.
Debbie, where the hell have you been?
It's a long story.
Looks like a bite pattern.
It's fairly new. There, so.
at your rifle. She's here.
So after we killed it, we left. It's over. That's it.
So when are you coming home?
As soon as Mike and Shane get out, they're getting stitches.
Guess what?
What?
Brian proposed to me.
Oh, really? Angela, oh my god, that's wonderful. When's the wedding?
November, I can't wait. Okay, all right. Bye. Brian?
Angela?
Thank you.
Debbie, listen to me. Get out of the house now! Debbie! Come in! Debbie! 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 Damn it, she's cut off! Go, Morty, go!
That was their van.
Turn around!
Roger on Union 121.